right, are you ready? We certainly are. This is the biggest Big Bang we've ever had. That's awesome. I think we have over 450 people here to learn and get deep. We're excited that we have people here from all across the country. We're excited we have people here from other places outside of the U.S., from other countries. And we're super excited to be doing our 20th anniversary here in New Orleans. So if you haven't noticed, this is a city that is rich in culture, extremely diverse. It's open to change, and it has a lot to do with why we've chosen to be here. So we're really excited. My name is Eunice Mitchell. If I had it my way and I had planned this a little bit better, I would have had a couple old school hip hop songs playing, like They Call Me D-Nice, because they call me E-Nice. I'm super excited to say that I hail from the beautiful city of Philadelphia, for those from Philadelphia. That's right, we get down. But I also represent a large region, so I wanna get all my people excited from New Jersey. We got folks from Montclair, Newark, where's Mencia? Go, 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 Dr. Sam. We got folks from Perth Amboy in New Jersey. Woo! Folks from Camden, across the bridge from Philly, let's go. All right, love it, love it. We have folks from Delaware, our brand new school. Delaware Met, Charlie's giving you guys the pound, I don't know really. Black Power Movement. We got folks from Philadelphia, I said, that's it in Philadelphia. We have folks both from our El Centro school and also from String Theory, another school, so just wanted to recognize them. You're in the room, that's right, make some noise. Kentucky's in the house. Kentucky's in the house. Any other southern state? I know we have some folks from DC here. Okay. There's one person from DC, he's in my advisory. I know he's here. No? You don't want to clap because you're by yourself? That's all right. And I represent all the southern states, so if I missed you, you can shout out now. Oklahoma, there we go. Nashville's not in the house, but they will be tomorrow or later today. Arkansas, you're in the south, that's right. Coming to you very soon. And I'm gonna pass it off to Jeff to talk about his region.
Hi, I'm Jeff. I think it's my turn. I'm Dana Luria. Good morning, everybody. I have a very loud region, and they are going to prove that right now. But we're going to start small. We have some friends from Connecticut who are big picture curious. Yes, that is a term. So, Connecticut. My Detroiters are small and mighty. Woo! See, Sharon, she's small and mighty. I don't know you guys, but New England, like all of New England, I'm supposed to welcome you right now. So, see, you are loud. Yes. And look at these beautiful Met people with their blue tie-dyed shirts. Admire those. Those are nice. I do want one. How do I get one? Can I buy one? I bet it's an East Center thing. Is it? It's all an East Center thing. I'm going shopping with the East Center people. And last, but certainly not least, where are my New York City people? Woo! We got lots of people from the Bronx and one lovely person from Brooklyn. We are so happy you guys are here. I'm handing it off to Jeff. Oh, I'm a person from Brooklyn, but really Detroit.
Good morning, I'm Jeff Petty. I'm a person from Seattle, and I love the term big picture curious. I'm not big picture curious, I guess I'm big picture out for a number of years, but I'm gonna start using that term. I'm really excited to be here as you'll figure out if you haven't already, we do regions in a very strange, not very geographic way. So I'm really excited to be here with Oklahoma as part of a skewed version of the Northwest. Where's Oklahoma? Tulsa. And it's not private anymore. Idaho is now no longer big picture curious. There's a big group from Idaho here. and also a bunch of people here from Seattle and the Seattle area. Thank you, Lenny. That's Lenny Haynes from one more time, Lenny Haynes from Seattle. And also, there's folks from Highline Big Picture. Welcome, Tim and Kelly, and the big city of Chelan. That's the hand over there under the light. So welcome, Northwest, and I'll turn it over to my good friend, Javier.
Good morning, everybody. I'm from originally from the East Coast, New York, so big up to the East Coast, New York City peeps. But I did have to go back to Cali. So to continue to confuse you about geography, I have California and Nevada. So big shout out to MedSac, MedWest, San Diego Med, New Village Girls Academy, and everyone else from California. I do want to give a shout out to Reno. I'm going to start working with the Reno folks this year. And if I can have you guys just stand up and show your awesome t-shirts. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. It's okay to be jealous. So I'm super psyched about this, being at Big Bang. I haven't been here in a while because it always conflicted, but I think this is gonna be the best one yet. And I'm really excited about being part of this movement that's about to take off, okay? And here is
Well, hey Jennifer. Guys, I'm Jennifer Gadu. I am so excited to be here. So I am the regional director in states that were not previously mentioned. And also, I do the data and research organization for Big Picture. So a lot of you I hassle because I love you and I want your data. It's love. But I want to give a shout out to a few of the schools that I work with that I love that are here. And the first off is Leominster Center for Excellence. Where are you, Leominster? Leominster's definitely small but mighty. Leominster went Big Picture last year. Amazing, amazing team, amazing leader. I also want to give a shout out to a school that is opening its doors in a couple weeks and is in the city where I live, which is Rochester, New York. So where are my East Big Picture peeps? I expect you guys to be making a lot of noise. All right, there they are. And I also work with a variety of schools, some of which whom are here and some of which whom are not. But I want to give a shout out to a school that's opening its doors next year, which is in St. Paul. The Phillips Community School. Where are you guys at, Rachel? There they are, in the back. And all the Midwest peeps, I want to give you guys a shout out. And I also wanted to say a couple schools that are close to my heart are in other regions that I don't serve, but I want to also say I love you, Met East. I also want to say I love you, El Centro. We have a big El Centro community here today. And if any of you guys have any questions about any of our research initiatives, I have a workshop happening at 1 o'clock today, and you can find me anytime and talk to me about that.
She's good. Hi, I'm Viv, Viv White from Australia, and I'm a long way away. And I've actually, for the first time in my very long life, because I feel extraordinarily old looking at all you wonderful young people in the room, been asked to represent the world. Like, that's pretty amazing, you know? Hello, world, you know, wow. Usually I'm only allowed to represent me, you know, because I'm so badly behaved and such a troublemaker. So what I thought I would just do is say thanks again and let you know that not only is it your 20th anniversary here in the US, but it's our 10th in Australia. And I just like to, and I know you'll be really embarrassed, but I'd just like to honour Elliot just for this one moment, because he gave such a great gift to us when he came to visit us in Australia. And we've been working together now for 10 years. And Dennis, I love you too, but I haven't had you down in Australia yet. So, but for Elliot, thanks so much for helping us get going in Australia. I think that's what you all call a shout out, but we don't do those in Australia. Can I also just be to honour the rest of the world that's here, just so you know, there's over 100, between 150 and 200 other schools outside the US. And many of them, their teachers and colleagues and kids have been to your schools. Javier, my last visit to a school was at Javier's school when he was at New Village. And one thing he said to me just stuck so clearly in my heart. He said, when you start, do it aggressively. Aggressively implement the design for these young people. I'd like to honour Maggie from MedEast Providence, Rhode Island, a young girl who was with me last week in Sydney. She's travelled to be with us and do her final year project in New South Wales on homelessness. And I met Peyton last night, and I don't know whether she's in the room, but she's on her way to visit us too. So it's just fantastic. Our young people are adventurous, they're travelling, they're joining up, and we've got this wonderful international movement. So my friends from the rest of the world, can my Kenyan friends stand up? We've got people from Kenya. We've got people from Belize. Where are you? Hey. We have people from Australia. And the Netherlands. And Italy. Buongiorno. From Canada. Woo! New Zealand. I whispered that one because they've only just got in and they're very tired. Israelis, where are my Israeli friends? Yo! And I hope, are there any countries I've forgotten? I hope not. Thanks for having us. We're looking forward to this great big bang. And happy birthday, everybody. I've forgotten one last thing. It was on my script. I'm so sorry. US, the rest of the world, now we're going out of space. We're starting a new big picture planet.
Stop him, Obi Elliott!
There is no thing as a
standardized kid.
We need to blow it up.
We do. There it is! Get ready to drop them!
Here we go!
Get ready to fire! We did it! Woo!
Yes! Be calm, everybody! This is just the beginning! We must learn from what just happened.
Keep on using the Force.
We're ready. We're ready to use the Force.
We've been out, traveling, through time and space, fighting the forces of darkness in education. These Jedi Masters for 20 years have been leading us through a difficult struggle. But we've been learning, and now you are here, and there is good within you. I can feel it.
That's right. That's right. And you're all here with us amongst the clouds where you all belong. And we know we cannot do it alone. It'll take all of us to continue to battle the forces of evil. Right on.
Hey, Chewie, what are you doing here? You're supposed to be with me tomorrow at the Chewbacca's crew, the garage. What are you doing here today, man? You got something to tell us today? You got something to tell us? Come on. Those of you who can't make it tomorrow, Chewie's got something to say.
Hi, guys. I'm not actually Chewbacca. I'm Ryan Ballard. I'm the captain of the intergalactic crew Chewbacca's science fiction-themed Mardi Gras parade crew here in New Orleans. And tomorrow, we're going to welcome you guys to our den over in the Bywater across town. And we're going to show you some videos and show you all of our parade contraptions and show you around and let you see sort of the wonderful collaborative makerspace type organization that we run and the place that we run it in. Woo! Right on. We're happy to have you all tomorrow.
So, there is much to learn. You still have just the beginning. I was looking to take the mustache off. I will end with do or do not. There is no try. You know, you think Yoda can levitate, but yesterday we went to the store and Yoda bought his new LeBrons down there, and that's what helps him get up in the air. So I just want all of you to see those. They help a little bit when we get to our age, right? So welcome, everybody. The bird up there is the Sankofa bird. That's the theme of our conference. And as you see, it says honoring the past, creating the future. And there's a little egg there, and the eggs are going to be important as we go on through the conference, because the eggs stand for that bird and her baby and going into the future and being well attached as you leave someplace. And that's very, very important. So we're going to take you through a little bit of history, a big picture, the first few years, and Dennis is going to start us off here. Oh, Yoda. Oh, who are you now?
So, 45 years ago, raise your hand if you weren't born 45 years ago, man. Shit. 5 years ago, Ellie and I met. How's that? So I was a young professor at Stony Brook University, and in walks this hippie with hair past his butt, a dog to my class, and his girlfriend. And that's how we met. And I started a program there, and then he finished. I left to start a school. He moved to New Hampshire. 10 years later, I moved to New Hampshire. We ran into each other, actually on the street, and then started working together. So Elliot's like 15 years as a teacher. My 20 years as a principal, we started getting together and say, it wasn't enough what we were doing. How do we take it to the next step? How do we take our practice that we were doing and really try to move it to policy, move it up a step? So then we got invited to come to Brown University in Providence, where I'd been working with Ted Sizer for the Coalition of Essential Schools. We went there, and then we decided, you know what? Brown's an elitist school on the Hill. The Department of Ed can't get anything done. We need to start our own something to spread the word. And that's when we started Big Picture, okay? And we called it Big Picture, and Ellie will talk a little bit, because it's just not about what you do in the classroom. It's beyond that. It's about the equity. It's about the poverty. It's about the health. Everything is involved. So we started that. We got ourselves a cool board of one angel who had a lot of money, who then they wouldn't mess with us, a couple big educators, and we just began. And then we said, the commissioner asked us, would you do this school? And we thought we were just kind of spreading the word. And that's when the Met started. So the Met started in 1996. We started Big Picture in 95. And our board, we were trying to do both and said, do the school and do it well. Okay? So if you do it well, then people will come to you. So everyone kind of laughed at us when we started the school. Here's the beauty, and this is what moves me when I see all you people. We started with 50 people in 1996. We had no clue where this was going. But we got 50 kids. We got our 50th kid and a $400,000 budget. The day school started. They tried to stop us. You know, what you also don't know, or you also have it, that people have been fighting us all the time. And that was part of the Star Wars. All the time. Even to get the school started, somebody raised an amendment to take our money and put it into the Providence schools. And then there was just about a physical fight in the parking lot with the Black Caucus, and they put it back. And then all through this has been fights. And I get fired everywhere I go. I'll talk about that a little later. So, and Ellie and I aren't sure if we got kicked out of Brown or we left Brown. We're not sure.
We got fired.
It was very close. And then what happened is we just did our job. And then in the year 2000, we graduated our first 50 kids. And that's when the Gates Foundation started to give money to education. So they sent their head guy down to us. He talked to Elliot and I for about an hour and a half, said, enough BS. I'm going to talk to the kids. So actually, I will tell the story. He walks in the cafeteria, and I had one girl. This is a public cafeteria. We were in a public building. And one girl that would drop the F-bomb 5 times a day to be cool and just to upset everyone in the building. And I'm going, the guy from Gates is here, the head guy, and I got Susan, who's going to say the F-word 5 times. Oh, my gosh. And as he's walking in, I remembered Susan was absent that day. I swear to God. She's my friend now. I hug her every time I see her, and thank God. And Tom Van Der Ark walked out. This never happened to us before or after. He looked at Elliot and I and said, your kids are so passionate about learning. Here's $5 million. Give me 10 schools. Put them wherever you want. We kind of fell on the floor, got up. You want to say that again? And he said, yeah, here's $5 million. Let's go. And then they continued to give us money. So that's how we made it to where we are today. So,
yeah. So thanks. So, Brian, you're going to give us a slide here? So when Dennis was talking about...
That was the last slide, Brian.
No, it's all right. That's
good.
That's it. Okay. So when when Dennis was talking about one student at a time, we said there's issues of equity out there across race, class, and gender, and our school's going to deal with it. We're also going to deal with who each and every student is in relation to the world, to their families, to their communities, who they are and the things they want to do and become, and how do they make their way in the world. So equity to us became a very, very big issue around each and every student. And we were really, and still probably are, one of the few and only groups that took school, which is based on a class as the lowest common denominator, to go into each and every student as the lowest common denominator. Nobody ever did that before. Even when John Dewey was around doing his thing, his lowest common denominator was a class doing projects together. And we said students would form their work and organize their groups and their affinities and the people that they wanted to have relationships with around each and every student and figure out how to make their way in the world. And arguably, that's the work, and that's one of the biggest changes that we made in American public education and internationally. So Dennis, you're going to
talk about mesh.
Oh, I'm going to talk about mesh too. So give us another slide, please. So I was in France a few weeks ago, and I've been playing around a lot with cording. How do you make cord? How do you make twine? Every culture in the world makes cord and twine. I did a little workshop in Vermont last year, and a few people were here. Yeah. And it turned out that hardly anybody knew how to twine, make cord. And the word cord comes from heart, cordata, which is a twist. And the computers that we have use cords as their base because a cord is a memory device. People think that cognition is just what you say and in your mind, but it's also in your body. There's embodied cognition. So when you look at that meshwork, not a network, but a meshwork, because a network is A to B to C straight lines, not organic, artificial. A meshwork is twists and turns and nodes and memories. And when you're here in this group and who we are as people, we form those twists and turns and relationships in the things that we do, what we say to each other, and how they make those kinds of connections. They're not straight lines. So this is the work that you all have to do here in the next few days, is create this continuous meshwork that we're weaving and evolving together.
And we'll end up, this has become a movement. This is not a fad, it's not new math, new science, a new STEM, STEAM program. This is something that is based on learning theory from a long, long time ago. I'm trained as a psychologist. It follows everything we know about how people learn. All the new brain research is coming out. So I think the important thing is we got it right in the kind of, in the direction we should go. And what's become a movement is we got thousands of students. We got schools all over the place. This is becoming something very big. It ain't going away. And one of the reasons Ellie and I have been doing this for 20 years, and we're not going away, but we're moving the organization, getting it all set up with Andrew and Carlos, so that another 20 years, they're ready to move it on. You're not waiting until it's not going anywhere. This is a movement. This is what we set up at the Met in 1996. Should look very different from what you guys are setting up. And if you know the history of movements, it's not one big thing. It's about little things that get started. It happened the labor movement, happened the civil rights movement. So each of you have that responsibility. If you can do your school and do it right, then you might think, oh, I'm just here in this little rural area or just in this city. But it's going on all around, and that becomes the movement, and that becomes something big. And right now what's happening, there's a backlash to a lot of the testing stuff, and so people are coming out of the woodwork and saying, oh, maybe it works. Oh, you've been around for 20 years. So I just appreciate all the people here. It's amazing to me as I walk around and understand that we started with five teachers. You know, we all fit on an elevator, man. And here we are today. Thank you very much. And I just hope that you use these days to learn, to laugh, to have fun, and to connect. And what we always say is we have fun here, but it don't mean nothing if you don't go back and really do it at your home.